This is Musafir here from Nes Health Kitchen, and today I'm going to show you a delicious recipe by my sister. Her name is Aisha. She's given me a delicious recipe to share with you guys. She's always fond of searching the best recipes and giving it to me so that I share you worldwide. So guys, discuss with her mom. I know she collects all kinds of recipes, ingredients, the changes and all, and brings it out to me so that I can share it openly worldwide. So this is a peanut, tomato, onion twist chutney. A peanut chutney with tomato and onion twist. So now we will start with the ingredients. Come on guys.
Here I have approximately 2 large tomatoes. 1 cup, a little bit less or more according to your taste, peanuts. Tamarind to taste. 1 tablespoon of pounded garlic. Not fine, just coarsely pounded or roughly pounded garlic. Salt according to your taste. Asafoetida, that's hing. It comes 1/4 of a teaspoon or 2 or 3 pinches. Few leaves of curry leaves. Onions, that is 1 large onion slice or medium 2 onions. Chili, green chili or red chili according to your taste. I'll be using here just 1 chili, two deseeded, as we have very less of spice at home. We don't like much of chili. Then here I have cubes of sugar. You can use granulated sugar. And guys, you can use even jaggery other than the sugar. The jaggery is nothing much, which you say good in local language. Then here I have til, that is sesame seeds. You can use it if you don't have peanuts at home. You can use it in the option of peanuts. I have some oil for cooking. I'll be using olive oil here. You can go ahead and use any kind of oil, mostly sunflower oil. But peanut oil tastes the best. As it's peanut recipe. And apart from that, other than til, that is sesame seeds, I would like you to use peanuts. As for this chutney, it's mostly peanut chutney and tastes best with peanuts itself. Now we'll start with the preparations. So now we will be taking a pan, add nice amount of oil. That's approximately 2-4 tablespoons of oil. Once your oil is hot, so guys, once your oil is nice hot, we'll be adding the onions and curry leaves. And fry them nicely till they sweat and become slightly golden. Just sweat and become soft. So guys, once you fry your onions, I have just added few peanuts. I would like to have taste more peanuts. So it's not a must. Then I will be adding the pounded garlic, then chili, mix well, fry for some time. Don't cook or fry the garlic for a longer time as it loses its intensifying aroma. The asafoetida, that's hing, and a pinch of salt according to your taste. I mix all the ingredients. Guys, if you feel the masala is getting stuck at the bottom, we have to add even tamarind pulp. First we'll add the peanuts, mix them well. And then we'll be adding the tamarind according to taste. First we'll add the water as it's catching at the bottom. very little water, guys. See, I'm using a very small cup.
That.
So once you see that oil is just oozing, we'll be adding some tamarind pulp to taste. If you find any ingredient less, you can add into it. If you find oil, etc., you can just add. Now, once all the ingredients are fried nicely, we'll be adding the tomatoes. And we will fry the tomatoes till they become nice and soft on low flame. You can even close the lid so that they easily and become soft faster. And we'll be cooking. And keep checking in intervals of time so that it doesn't burn and catch at the bottom. So guys, now after some time, I'll just open the lid to see if they have done. Yeah, guys, as I can see here, it becomes soft and I can get nice intensifying aroma. I'll switch off the volume of the flame and I'll leave it to cool down. Once it's cooled down, we'll be making it into a fine paste, that is chutney. So guys, once your masala is come to the room temperature, I have already been putting it into the mixer grinder. Now I'll be running it into smooth paste, and in intervals of time we will check if we need some water, then we will add a bit amount of water too. Now I'll be adding some water to make the blending easy. So guys, once you make it into smooth paste, this is the time when you can add your granulated or cubed sugar according to your taste, and just taste a bit of chutney to see whether salt, etc., tamarind paste, etc. are proper. If you need to add more, you can go ahead and add more of it. Then we will removing it in the bowl. So guys, once you remove the chutney into the bowl, now it's the time for seasoning it or tempering it. The ingredients what you need for tempering is some olive oil. You can use even sunflower oil, any oil. Then mustard seeds, maybe a half a teaspoon, as you can see here, mustard seeds, oil, mustard seeds, maybe half a teaspoon mustard seeds, and asafoetida, that's thing, that's according to your taste. Now we will start the preparation of tempering. So guys, once your oil is hot, we'll be adding mustard seeds, that's approximately half a teaspoon. And close the lid in order to avoid a mess all around the house as it just stutters. So guys, once you add the mustard seeds, cook them till you get the aroma and they slightly get burnt. Then we will be adding a bit of hing. Hing, that's asafoetida. When your oil is come down slightly to cooler temperature, as soon as you fry the mustard seed, you should switch off the flame. And then when it comes to, then when your oil cools down a bit, then we'll be adding hing. Once you add hing, then we will be taking this oil. Then we'll be adding this into the chutney. So guys, I have garnished it with lovely dry leaves and chilies, etc.
So guys, here I have the yummy peanut chutney with tomato and onion twist. You can have it with rice, boiled rice, chapatis, parathas, and mostly it tastes delicious even with idlis, guys, dosas, etc. So please guys, don't forget to like and subscribe my video.